So I came to give you what God gave me, and I'm going to move on out the way. And if you will, hold your Bibles in your hand as you stand with me. Amen. Here at Now Covenant Word, we believe in making a proclamation. Amen. When you make a proclamation, you tell God, Lord, I trust you, and I give you total autonomy of my life. Amen. How many of you really believe in God today? Amen. Oh, come on, stop saying it. Y'all to make this declaration and this proclamation in faith. Amen. Yes. This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I believe what my Bible says.
I believe what my Bible says.
I believe I can do all that my Bible says that I can do.
I believe I can do all my Bible says I can do.
I believe that I can have all that my Bible says I can have.
I believe I can have all my Bible says I can have.
I am.
More than a conqueror.
And new members, feel free to praise God in here. Amen. Ain't nothing shameful in the praise of God. Matter of fact, David said to enter into his courts with thanksgiving and to come into his presence with praise. Amen. How many of you know that the sin has already been saved? The sin was said at Calvary's cross. Amen. Oh, they thought it was a sad thing to cry about it, but because he died, we can live. Oh my God. Oh, y'all don't hear anything. I need you to turn into your Bibles to 1 Samuel, the 17th verse. The 17th chapter, I'm sorry. Amen. And when you have it, please stand on your feet with me. Amen. There is a word from God. We're going to be starting at the 20th verse. Amen. And I will acknowledge it. If you don't have a Bible, stand on your feet anyhow. Amen. And acknowledge and reverence for the things of God. Chapter 17 and the 17th verse, I will read. And David rose up early in the morning and left the sheep with a keeper and took and went as Jesse had commanded him and came to the trench as a host going forth to the fight and shouted for the battle. For Israel and the Philistines had put the battle in array, army against army. And David left his carriage in the hands of his keeper of the carriages and ran into the army and came and saluted his brother. And as he talked with them, behold, there came up the champion of the Philistines of Gath, Goliath by name, out of the armies of the Philistines, and spake according to the words. And David heard him, and all the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him and was so afraid. And the men of Israel said, have ye seen this man that it came up surely to defile Israel? Is he come up? And it shall be that the man who killeth him the king will enrich him with great riches and will give him his daughter and make his father's house free in Israel. And I'm going to stop right there for now. Father God, as we come before you today, Lord God, I submit myself to you. Father, I hide behind the cross, God, that it's going to be less of me and more of you, God. Father, I need you to speak today, God, because I can't go, God. I can't do, God, without you, God. Father, I'm worthless without you. So, Father, I ask now, God, that you just rain down on me, God, that I might pour out upon your people, God, an anointed word, God. Father, make me a flame of fire, God. Father, that I will speak to your people, God, that somebody will be encouraged, God. Somebody will give a breakthrough. Somebody, God, needs to overcome today, God. Father, you are the author and the finisher of our faith, Lord God. And Father, we trust you and we can't trust ourselves. So, Father, speak to our hearts. Holy Spirit, speak to our minds. Father, speak to our innermost being, because they all belong to you. Now, Father, I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart will be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And the redeemed of the Lord said, amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. See, we see here that this is a tale, the story that's in the Old Testament, the Pentateuch, one of David. We knew that David was a shepherd boy. David was a running guy. He was the one that was least of all of Jesse's children. But there was something special about David that was given even when he was born. See, some things that we don't realize as the children of God is that God already has ordained you for something in your life. Now, as we come up, we see that David has left what his natural calling was, which was to be a mere shepherd boy, to run to the battle. Amen. Y'all know how we do. If a fight break out, you can be in the kitchen in your house, and you hear the ambulance and the police come, the first thing you do is run and look out. We get nosy. We want to see what's going on. We don't even care if they shoot. But David was not just a typical teenager. He wasn't the ordinary type of guy. He was one that had purpose in his life. And, you know, he was one that God even said, he's a man of my own heart. Now, when we look at David, we see that David was going to battle where his brothers were already fighting. And when David comes on the scene, we see that there's a champion on the other side. That side called the Philistines. Philistines were a great nation, not just any typical nation, but they were a nation of conquering warriors. The Philistines were a nation that when the men were born, they were already taught to fight. Now, in the process of this, we see that now they come up against Israel once again to bring them in to captivity. But what I find strange in all of this is that now Israel has a king. How many of you know that sometimes what man says is the head, God had made the head. Now, this was a fight that David had to go fight. And some would even say that it wasn't his fight. Now we see that this champion comes up, and how many of you know that sometimes it's got to be one-on-one? So we see that Goliath comes forth and he begins to call them out one by one. And if there's somebody bold enough to come and take me on, well, we'll just settle this all right now. But everybody is afraid. Everybody is scared of this Philistine. I want you to look to your neighbor right now, whether it be to the left or the right, and ask your neighbor a question. Ask your neighbor, neighbor, what's your Philistine? Oh, yeah. See, because we all got some Philistines in our lives. Amen. Now, see, when we look at this Philistine, this wasn't the average
words, he was a giant. This was a big guy. Now, I was a grunt coming up, but guess what? I never backed down from a fighter. The bigger you are, the harder you gonna fall. Now, we see David coming forth, and we know now David. Let me tell y'all a little bit about David. David was one that was committed. And the thing that we don't have now in our Christian society is commitment. Now, David was committed because when he was supposed to tend the sheep, David tended the sheep. Oh, come on now. Some of us can't be trusted to wash a dish. Mama say wash the dishes and you try to put it off on somebody else. Pastor say, I need you to come and clean the church and you pass it on alone, not knowing that God gonna bless you for doing what was given. Now in the process of David coming up, David knew how to fight. See, sometimes God is teaching us how to fight in the least expected circumstances. Oh, come on now. You remember the last time you was brokenhearted, and you remember the last trial, and you didn't know how you was going to make it out, and God was teaching you how to fight. Ah, come on now, somebody got to be with me. Somebody done been in a hard spot in their life, and somebody done had a Philistine in their life that was bigger than them, and you didn't know how you was going to defeat it. Every time you turn around, it had you on the run. What's your Philistine? Oh my God. But see, David, he began to take on Philistines as a youth. I remember the first word the word told us is that there was a lion that came along and snatched up one of his sheep and was just a cloth and a stone. David went and took back what was his. Oh, come on now. A lion roars loud, and sometimes even the sound of it will scare us enough that we'll back down. Oh, come on now. You know when that bill collector call and they got that tone in their voice, and this is your final notice, and we tired of calling you, and matter of fact, we ain't even calling no more. Scares you, don't it? What I'm going to do now? What's going to happen next? But David wasn't worried. See, because there's a thing about when you trust God, that's enough. You ain't got to worry about how you fight. You better know how God fights. See, sometimes it's not meant for us to fight the battle, but it's meant for us to give it over to the Lord. Oh, we say we love the Lord, and I love God, but I don't know how to trust Him. Oh, my God. I'm trying to slow down because I want y'all to receive this, but I want to move on out the way. But then came a bear. Oh, y'all know. Bear comes up and he towers over everything. And you ever had that one, that situation that came into your life and it took what it wanted? Come on now. You thought you had some peace? It took your peace. You thought you had some joy? It took your joy. You thought your finances was all right? But all of a sudden, you down to your last dime. That's that bear in your life. That's that thing that's coming up crowding. And I come to snatch what's yours and ain't nothing you can do about it. But how many of you know today, the bear might growl and he might show his teeth, but all you need is a rock in your hand. All you need is a rock in your hands. And if I got a rock in my hands, I believe he'll put a little power behind it. Yeah. Oh, come on. Yeah. See, God is looking for some people that's ready to throw some rocks. Throw some rocks at the bear. The one that's coming to steal your child. Coming to take your family. Coming to take your peace. Coming to steal your joy. Oh, but you ain't got to be scared right now. Oh, it's okay. Be afraid, but don't be scared. Oh, see, there's a difference between being scared and being afraid. If I'm scared, I'm paralyzed. But how many of you know right now, if I'm afraid, I'll fight even harder. Because I don't know what you're going to do to me. I gotta do it to you before you do it to me. And David went to work. So as David began to go to work, He slew the bear. Can you imagine the pelts this man was beginning to collect? I got a bear head on the wall. I got a lion's head in front of the fireplace. God was setting him up. How many of you know those were things only the kings wore? But see, David didn't realize he was already a king. See, what y'all don't realize, y'all are already kings. Y'all are kings because you have an inheritance. Because you are inheritance of the things of Jesus. You are an heir and a joint heir with Christ. Somebody say, I'm ready to throw a rock.
Ready to throw a rock.
Now see, as David went through, he didn't realize that he was building up a resume. Y'all know what a resume is. You know when you're going to look for that job. You want that thing to be picture perfect. You want it to say everything about you and then some. You want them to know who you are before you step on the scene. Or when you come through the door, they already know you got the skill it takes. Resumes. David's resume was already being put together. Even from that time as a youth. Now, what the king didn't know is that he had already sent the priest, the prophet, to anoint David as king. Oh my God. How many of you know sometimes that battle was your anointing? That thing that you couldn't get over, that was the oil pouring down on you. That was your newness to life. That was your very resurrection. That was the pain that was going to bring you into your blessed place. Come on. The word said, count it all joy when we fall into diverse trials and tribulations. Oh, I ain't got to cry about it. I ain't got to be scared of it. Oh, because there will be victory after this. Oh, it might look like I'm losing right now. But how many of you know you can fight hard from your back? See, David runs up to the battle and he hears all of this. But what amazes me the most is that, now wait a minute, we know if we have a king over us, just like we trust our president, should no harm come to us. It doesn't happen to you before it happened to me. Come on, you little joker run up in my house and try to do something to my wife. I hate it for him. It's going to happen to me before it happened to her. You better know it. We got to protect her just the same way. Now they had a king at this time, Saul. But how many of you know some people think they are, but they really aren't? See, because a new king had already been anointed. Now, it was his responsibility to go fight that battle. Oh, my God. David was just coming on the scene. But how many of you know he was doing exactly what God had purposed him to do? Saul sitting behind, scared to move. But he's supposed to be protecting us. This is our king. This is the one that he's supposed to make everything all right. He's supposed to go ahead of us. Oh, come on now. How many of you going to follow a coward? How many of you going to follow somebody into a battle that's scared to fight they say? They trying to push you ahead of you. No, you go. No, you go. No, you go. He can say, well, come on, let's us go. You should say, no, you go. Oh, my God. But Saul was ready to give rewards, give his own child for somebody that will go in his stead. How many of you know sometimes when them battles come to you, when your Philistine is coming, you thought it was meant for somebody else and somebody else was supposed to take care of it? It was really meant for you. You're supposed to fight that battle because you've already been anointed as king. Oh, my God. Oh, y'all hearing me today? Some of y'all got an anointing on your life and the devil trying to pull it out of your life, but he can't take what God has given you. Because what God has for you, it's for you. The devil might say, I come to steal, kill, and to destroy, but you can't destroy this. Oh, because all I got to do is submit myself, therefore, to God. When I submit to God, you got to flee. Oh, come on now. How many of you know even the bully got a limitation? Oh, come on. The devil ain't nothing but a bully. He wants to bully you, but you got the peacekeeper on your side. Oh, come on. Y'all remember how it was when you was growing up. Your big brother went to the fight too. Even though you was the peon, you was the loudest one. I can say, come on over here if you want to. You're walking over, but you're limping back. You know you can't fight, but big brother standing there behind you. Oh, yeah. Big Will with him. He got Big Ron with him. Hey, we don't need much. We gonna move on. They ain't gonna do too much. Cause they know Big Ron. He know how to throw them bows. You step in, you're not walking back. Oh my God. We got to stop being scared of the devil. But as this Philistine was threatening the very army of Israel. Y'all know even today Israel is the largest army in the world. They have the largest army in the world. And what makes me wonder is why in the world, y'all know how we used to rush them? Yeah. Talk junk to one, you finna get us all. But the king stands back and he don't fight a battle. But it wasn't meant for him to fight that battle. Because God had already chosen another one because of his disobedience. How many of you know right now, your obedience is going to be your very breakthrough to what God has for you? Oh, come on, I can't be obedient sometimes and disobey all the other times. David didn't even know he was going for a fight. He was being obedient to what his daddy told him. Take this bread and take these barley of wheat. To your brothers. And when they got there, the brothers started messing with him. You coming to be nosy. You just want to see a fight. They didn't know that he was going to be the main participant. He was going to be the golden card. Now see, in the process of this fight getting ready to happen, David tells the king, I'll fight for you. How many of you know that when somebody else scared to do what they need to do, they're quick to hand it off? See, we as the people of God got to be even quicker to accept the things of God. Amen. See, because this is what I know above and beyond everything. That all things work together for the good of them that love God and are called according to his purpose. Amen. Guess what? That's me. No matter what it is, no matter how it's happening, I'm chosen of God. How many of you know, I don't care how saved you are, how long you've been saved, you never chose God. God chose you. So guess what? God got a responsibility. And if you will allow him to do what he needs to do in your life, things will begin to turn around. Or we holler, I need a turnaround. I need a blessing. But we don't want to submit ourselves to God. And we quick to quote the scripture. Resist the devil and he'll flee. You think the devil's scared of you? And you got some word. But you think he's scared? He got some word too. But it's only when we submit ourselves to God will he flee. See, the Philistines in our lives only come in our lives to fall down. Oh, y'all remember the bigger they are, the harder they fall. The giants in your life ain't really giants at all. It's going to be a giant blessing for you if you go forth and receive the victory of Christ. But see, what we got to realize is that David went forth not in full beguile. Saul tried to put his armor on him and tried to give him a big heavy sword. And how many of you know you can't go judo if you ain't never took one class? You will step on the mat and get whooped. Oh my God, and wonder, wait a minute, I got on all the right equipment, but you don't know how to fight. But why don't we try to fight battles that we know we shouldn't be fighting? The word of God says, stand still and know. When I stand still and know, I see the salvation of the Lord. See, he said, the battle is not mine to fight, but it's his. Amen. So why don't we just give it back to him and, Lord, I'm going to stay put. He said, no, I need you to pick this rock up. Yeah, that rock called Jesus. And I'm going to give you a little something spinning around. Get a little momentum on it. How many of you know you got to get some momentum behind your prayers? See, y'all didn't realize it takes a little something to get some momentum going. See, you know, momentum causes speed, and speed causes velocity, and when velocity comes forth, you got power. Amen. When that power goes forth, you got something that's going to destroy whatever it was meant to destroy. Oh, come on now. Come on. It ain't prospering, but I'll just do it again. family is a wreck. You better get it on the run. You better be ready to fight for yours. Devil, I'm bold and I'm standing in your face right now. I come to tell you I'm taking it all back. You thought you had me. You thought I was defeated. But when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me, somebody had to step on the battleground. Somebody had to be willing to fight. Now see, he walked up, but he didn't know he wasn't going to be able to walk back. See, that's how your Philistine come in your life. It came to take you over. It came to push you down, hoping you wouldn't get back up. But how many of you know right now, when you begin to fall down, when you begin to get down, when you let someone respect you, champion fighting on your side. He says you're more than a conqueror. And the battle has already been won. Oh, he thought he had you. He had already walked miles on your shoulders. But God said, I'm going to send him a little grace. I'm going to send him a little more mercy. If he receives this, I'm going to send him the Holy Ghost. Come in. They said David walked across a little pond. As he walked across the wood, he picked up three stones. I can imagine. And instead, thinking in the spirit, one for the Father, one for the Son, and this is for the Holy Ghost. But that's only going to take one. Because the three make one. Somebody throw a rock. Throw a rock at your situation. Throw a rock at your tribulation. Throw a rock at your burden. Throw a rock at your generational curse. Throw a rock at that thing that think it's got you. You better tell it with an assurity. You ain't got what you think you got. Ooh, Jesus. Somebody give God just a little praise. Something towers over you, they feel like it's got you. Oh, come on. It feels like it has so much power over you, I ain't got to put much effort. I'm going to blow you off. How many of you know, when it comes to the child of God, they ain't got enough wind to blow. Because God's breath brings life. And in your dead situation, you better start to speak life and speak it more abundantly. See, there were some things David had to do. The first thing he had to do was face the situation. He had to face that Philistine. He had to look him dead in his face and know, I ain't afraid of you. Everybody else is scared. But scared ain't gonna stop me. See, because I know God has already said, you have a hope of glory for me. You've already spoken me into existence before the foundation of the world. So guess what? When he was calling your name, he was saying, you got victory over this baby. It might look like it's going to have you down, but blessings is coming your way. You are the head and not the tail. You're going to be blessed going in, blessed coming out. Blessed in the city. Blessed in the field. Blessed when you come and blessed when you go. You better walk and hold your head up like you know it. Come on. I can't look to God when I'm looking down. That was the reason he said, I'm the lifter up of your head. Because when my head is lifted up, I can see God. I can observe all of my surroundings. I can see the tricks of the devil. I can already see you trying it, but it's going to fail too. You tried that yesterday and it didn't work. Oh, come on now. You didn't have one speak death into your life. That didn't work either. Oh, you ain't worth nothing and I hope you die. But God said no, he going to live. And he going to live in abundance. Just so I can make a liar out of you.
So your Philistine, you better call it by his name and let it know, you uncircumcised Philistine, you unclean, vile, nasty, wretched, or how y'all say it, ratchet. You get nothing here but defeat. Somebody give God some praise. So as I close, I want you to know right now, don't be scared to go up against your giants. Face them head on. But when you go, have on the full armor of God. Be girded up. Have your blessed prayer on. Have your helmet on. Have your shoes shod. And have your sword in your hand. Knowing that I ain't come to lose, devil. But I came back to take your head. I can smile about it too. You know, some people think when you laughing in the midst of a hard trial, they'll say you crazy.